In this video, we want to cover how to place our on-screen calculators, what we call the dollar calculator, as well as the risk versus reward calculator within Track and Trade. I also want to make a note here that these features are exactly the same whether we're using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. You'll notice that I'm using the futures version in this demonstration. Selecting the dollar calculator is this dollar sign here. Very simply, it's used and designed to help us identify the amount of money that a specific trend is between two points on the chart. So, coming in and saying, I want to know how much this money is between how much money this is between this point and this point, we just simply hold down the left mouse button and drag the dollar calculator from top to bottom and release the mouse button, and it calculates for us. If this was a sell position, we would sell here and buy here. This would be a $1,900 profit potential or move in the market. Now you'll notice that by having the preferences tab selected that we have the preferences for the dollar calculator over here, where we can change the color, the look, the feel of the calculator, the line size, the line style, the thickness, and the color. We can also change the quantity that we're calculating. Right now we're calculating the default of quantity 1, but if we were trading 5 contracts, we might want to know what that is. We can also change the font size. I like to increase it a little bit sometimes and hit bold and make it a little bit easier to see. You'll notice that we also have the ability to show the text. If we select that, it turns the text off. And we can snap to, which allows us to snap it right to a specific point on the chart and snap it to an exact price level. We also have the ability to come in here and change it from the dollar value to the return on margin. You'll notice that we have a 274.5% return on margin, or the number of ticks. This is 302 ticks. Now if we're using percent return on margin, we can have the day margin, we can have it calculated on the initial margin, or we can calculate it on the maintenance margin, whichever you prefer. We can also type in the different points. If we would like to have a specified point, we can come in and say, I want to have it at exactly 1.7000, and I want this one to be at exactly 1.6888. And so we can put this at exactly the price levels that we would like to calculate the exact numbers or dollars that we would like to see. So you can see that there, or you can again drag it to the price levels you want with snapping it to the price bars themselves. To remove the dollar calculator, you can do that simply by right-clicking on it and selecting Delete in the right-click menu, or you can select it and hit the Delete key on your keyboard, which will delete the dollar calculator. The next calculator that I would like to represent or show to you is the risk versus reward calculator. Now the risk versus reward calculator is here with the red and the green calculator. When we select the risk versus reward calculator, it draws out from the center. So we're actually drawing the center or the risk section. And so this would be a place where we could bracket a market, maybe with a narrow sideways channel or a individual price bar like this, and we can calculate the risk versus reward ratios on a bearish and a bullish side of the market. And so if the market, if we buy at the break above the at this point here, which I'm going to use my arrow to point to, if we buy here and we sell here and we put a stop loss order right here, the risk would be a $580 risk for a $1,349 profit potential on the upside. Now you'll notice that when we select the risk versus reward calculator, if we have the preferences tab selected, we also receive a number of preferences over here, very similar to the dollar calculator. So if I want to come and change the colors, I can, the risk colors, the reward colors, the quantity, maybe I want to change the quantity, I can do that here. The price difference or the tick difference, how many ticks you're risking for how many ticks that your reward potential is. If we want to increase the font size, which I want to do here so you can see this a little bit better, and maybe make it bold so you can see it. We can also put in the exact points here. Maybe we want to have 1.7200, and this one here we want to have 1.6900, and this is 68.00, and we want this one to be 6600. So we can make these exact numbers by typing in over here rather than dragging them on the screen, which is a little less accurate. So now, this is our risk versus reward ratio calculator, based on the theory that if you are going to get into the market at one marker, this point here and put a stop loss order at the other inner marker. The risk versus reward potential would be in green and the risk would be in red. Again, on the downside, if you were to get into the market long on this one here, or short, excuse me, if you were to go short here and put your stop order here, you would be risking $625 with a reward potential if the market went to this point to maybe possibly a limit order where you took profits at this point, would be a $1,250 profit potential with a $625 risk. So this is your risk versus reward calculator. To remove it from the screen, very simply, you can right click on it and say delete, or if it's selected and where you have the handles that are movable handles, you can just hit the delete key on your keyboard and it is gone as well.